the daily average of the country's new COVID-19 cases in the past 7 days, up 50% from the previous week. More than 193,000 influenza-like illnesses have also been reported in the country since December 2nd. That number is 33% higher compared to the same period last year.
Mas madami na ang society or people moving around and intermingling. So tataas talaga ang respiratory illness.
Ang tinitingnan dyan sa epidemiologic surveillance ay yung trends. So it's not the actual number, it's the trend. Is it going up? Is it bigger than last year in the same time?
But Secretary Herboso notes, most patients of influenza-like diseases recover. While in Japan, President Marcos also weighed in on the removal of secret funds for the offices of Vice President Duterte in the final version of the 2024 budget. For him, the issue has been settled. Duterte earlier requested 650 million pesos in confidential funds for the office of the Vice President and the Education Department next year. This earned mixed reactions from lawmakers and the public, forcing Duterte to drop her bid. Marcos clarifies he was not behind the removal of the funds.
Well, that was actually the initiative of the Vice President. And when I'm talking about the confidential funds, and to not insist that they have such a confidential fund. So I think, as far as I'm concerned, it is a settled issue.
Marcos is expected to sign the 5.7 trillion peso spending bill Wednesday. A familiar name in the Philippine real estate sector joins the Marcos administration. President Marcos has tapped Robinsons Lands CEO Frederick Go as his special assistant for investment and economic affairs. Go is expected to help ensure investment pledges are realized and government policies and programs for the economy are implemented well. Go has a storied career in business, particularly in the Gokongwei Group, including as chairman of Robinson's Lands Commercial Right and a director of Cebu Air and Meralco. A warning from China, Beijing says the Philippines should not rely on major powers in its maritime dispute with China. It warns doing so would only provoke China, which could further escalate maritime tensions. China adds any attempt to force the country to back down will lead nowhere.
China has always been committed to maintaining peace and stability in the South China Sea through dialogue and consultations with ASEAN countries, including the Philippines. At the same time, China is resolute in its determination to safeguard its territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests. We hope the Philippines could realize that it is vain for it to pin the hope in tying itself up with certain major powers to corner China. Such attempts will ultimately harm its own interests and regional peace and stability.
China made those remarks in response to Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement in Japan. Marcos said a more assertive China is posing a real challenge to its neighbors in Asia. The Philippine leader also called the South China Sea situation the most complex geopolitical challenge that the world faces. President Marcos not keen on replacing Chinese ambassador to the Philippines, Huang Xilian. Several Philippine lawmakers have deplored Huang over his stance on the West Philippine issue, with some even urging government to declare him persona non grata. But Marcos says while he is upset over the envoy's remarks, the country cannot overreact on the matter.
Kung siguro akong personally ang pinag-usapan, maybe I'll be upset. But you're not talking about me, we're talking about the Philippines. So it doesn't serve any purpose for us to lose our temper or to overreact. I think Ambassador Huang is just doing his job. He's just doing his job. He's continuing to state the Chinese narrative. Of course, we don't agree with that narrative. But I cannot see him doing anything else. And so we just keep trying. We'll just keep trying. Because the truth of the matter is, kahit palitan, mapalitan na si Ambassador Huang, pareho pa rin ang sasabihin ng susunod na ambassador. Dahil yun ang linya ng China.
Marcos says the Philippines and Japan have agreed to quickly conclude talks on the reciprocal access agreement. Once approved, the RAA will boost the capabilities of the Philippines in terms of defense, security, and disaster preparedness. The deal is similar with Manila's visiting forces agreement with Washington. But Marcos clarifies the talks have nothing to do with the recent incidents in the West Philippine Sea.
It's been in the works for way before that. Of course, the incidents in the past few couple of months has certainly sharpened our focus when it comes to that. But again, that's one of the things that I'm looking forward to. That will be a big big multiplier effect to our capabilities. These are the kind of arrangements we are making not only with Japan, but also with other countries around China Sea in the Pacific, region, and it has become a very important part of these trips that we take.
President Marcos secures nearly 15 billion pesos in investment pledges during his visit to Japan. The palace says 9 deals were signed Monday at a business event led by the Philippine Trade Department during the ASEAN-Japan commemorative summit. The investments cover several industries such as infrastructure, retail, and electronics. The pledges will generate around 15,000 jobs for Filipinos.